Hi, this is Rumbut. Let's talk about setting up version control for Unreal Engine using Git and GitHub Desktop. Git helps you manage changes, collaborate, and protect your game projects from accidental loss. We'll use GitHub for cloud storage and GitHub Desktop to make things easier. You'll need a GitHub account and the GitHub Desktop app. Both are free to use. I'll start by creating a new Unreal project. You can use either C++ or Blueprint. There's no difference in the Git setup. For this example, I'm going with a first-person Blueprint template. Now, open GitHub Desktop, go to the top menu, click on File, then choose Add Local Repository. Browse to your Unreal Projects folder and select it, then click on Add Repository. You'll see a warning, this directory does not appear to be a Git repository. That's normal for a new project. Click on the link to create a repository here instead. On the Create a New Repository screen, name your project. The key setting here is the gitignore option. Select Unreal Engine from the dropdown. This will automatically generate a .gitignore file, making sure temporary and intermediate files don't clog up your repo. Keeping your repo clean saves space and prevents version control headaches. Click Create Repository. You'll see your project now tracked by Git. To sync with GitHub, click Publish Repository. Your project will now appear on your GitHub profile. Click View on GitHub. Version control is set up. If your project is small, under 500 megabytes or 1 gigabyte, regular Git is enough. But Unreal projects often include big binary assets like textures, audio, or animations. For these, Git LFS, large file storage, is essential. It keeps your repo fast and avoids problems with big files. To enable Git LFS, create a file in your project folder and name it .gitattributes. It should be generated by GitHub Desktop. If not, you have to create one. Place this file right next to your .gitignore. At the top of this file, add a line that tells Git to automatically detect text files and use line feed normalization. Star space text equals auto. After that, leave a blank line, then add another line that tells Git to use LFS for the folders you want. For example, if you want to use LFS for all files in your FPWeapon folder inside content, write this down, content/FPWeapon/*, then filter equals LFS, diff equals LFS, merge equals LFS, and minus text. Don't worry about memorizing this, just copy and paste from the description and change the folder name to match the ones you need for LFS. This setup makes sure large assets like textures or animations are stored with Git LFS, so your repository stays fast and clean. After setting up your .git attributes, return to GitHub Desktop. You'll see changes ready to commit. Write a message and commit. Publish again to sync with GitHub. To check your Git LFS storage, go to the GitHub website and click on your profile picture. From the dropdown, select Settings. Inside the Settings menu on the left, find and click on Billing and Plans. Then select Plans and Usage. Scroll down the page until you see the section for Git LFS data. Here, you can check how much LFS storage and bandwidth you've used. If you need more space, just click on Add More Data to see the available storage packages and purchase extra LFS storage for your project. To demonstrate how version control works, I'll add a new blueprint inside Unreal's content drawer and save it. When I switch to GitHub Desktop, you'll see the new assets show up as a binary file ready to be committed. Here's a handy tip. If you ever make a mistake or add a file by accident, just right-click the file before committing and choose Discard Changes. This lets you roll back any unwanted changes instantly. No stress. Once you're ready, type a commit message and push the change. Now your new asset is safely tracked on GitHub. Always use the unrealengine.gitignore template. Use LFS for large binary files and folders. Don't use it for code or small text files. Regularly push your commits to keep backups up to date. Monitor your LFS storage if your project grows. That's all for setting up version control with Unreal Engine and GitHub Desktop. You're now ready to collaborate, back up your project, and never worry about losing work again. Subscribe for more Unreal Engine tutorials. If you have questions or want a deep dive into Git LFS settings, let me know in the comments.